Hello students, today we are going to start with our moral science subject for standard 3. Children, this is your moral science textbook. Today we will start with the first lesson of it, that is a prayer. Before starting our first lesson, I request all of you to open your textbook and keep it in front of you. A prayer. Children, a prayer is a way to connect to God. It is a way to request God for helping or even to thank God for everything He has blessed us with. In this lesson, there is a story of a boy named Vikas and his father who went along the river Ganga in Haridwar. And there, Vikas' father explained him the importance of prayer and why, how, and where to perform prayer by giving him different examples of their own lives. So, let us read the lesson to see what the story is. Vikas and his father were walking along the river Ganga in Haridwar. He saw a man sitting all alone on the river bank. His eyes were closed. His palms were folded. He was sitting erect. Sometimes he would bring his head forward as though he was saying namaste to elders. "Who is this man, father?" Vikas asked. "What is he doing?"
"He is a devotee, Vikas," his father replied. "He is praying to God."
"Vikas, what is a devotee?"
"Father, a devotee is a person who worships God. He is devoted to God."
"Vikas, where does God live?"
"Father, God is everywhere all the time."
"Vikas, why do we pray to God?"
"Father, when someone gives you something or does something for you, you always say thank you. Whether it is mummy or daddy or your brothers, sisters, friends, or even a stranger who express your gratitude in this way. God has made the world and all the things in it, including you and me. So we must thank Him. We tell Him we are grateful for His grace."
"Vikas, but why is this man praying all alone? Can devotion be expressed only by praying in solitude?"
"Father, certainly not. But when you are alone, you do not get distracted. At home, if your little brother makes a noise while you are studying, you ask him to keep quiet, don't you?"
"Vikas, I asked him to keep quiet because I get disturbed. I am not able to concentrate on my work."
"Father, this is exactly the reason why it is better to pray in solitude. You can concentrate better on God in solitude. Vikas, what can I ask God for when I pray?
Father, well, Vikas, we don't pray only to ask for things. We also pray for forgiveness. We do say many wrong deeds. We say so many wrong things every day. We must admit what we have done in wrong and ask God to forgive us. Only then can we ask for something, because then our hearts become pure. It is a mistake to think that prayer is only a means of asking things from God.
Vikas, but Father, if we don't ask God, how will He give us what we need? How will He know what we want?
Father, when you were a baby, Vikas, you could not speak. You could not ask for anything. Yet, Mummy gave you all you wanted, all you needed. How did she know? In the same way, God knows. After all, He made the world. He made you. He knows what you want. You don't have to ask Him.
Vikas, can you tell me how to pray, Daddy?
Father, it's easy. Pray with a pure and grateful heart.
So children, from this lesson, we have learned today that God is everywhere all the time. God has made the world and all the things in it, including us. So, we must always thank God. Prayer is not only a means of asking things from God. We should also pray to God to forgive us for the wrong deeds we say or do every day, and by doing so, our hearts become pure. God knows everything as He made the world. So, we should always pray to God with a pure and grateful heart. Thank you.